Hi, I'd like to make this short video to just explain something that's causing a little bit of confusion with regard to using Google Drive. And it's probably easy to understand why it's a little confusing. So I'd like to clarify it once and for all. So I have two windows open here. One, let's say this belongs to the teacher. And the second one here, let's say this belongs to the student. So if you take a file, okay, now first of all, let's differentiate between a file and a folder. So a file, you know what that is, and in this case I'm talking about Google Documents, so Sheets, Docs, or Slides. And you can also have folders, and inside a folder you can have files. So I think we all understand that distinction. So you can take a document and you can share it with individual people. So I'm going to share this document with this person called DStudent. Okay, so with Demo Student, and I'll allow Demo Student to be an editor, and I'll click Send. And so what that's just done is it shared this file called Sample File with this user sitting here in the background. So let's switch over to the sample user. Now, where I would find that is in this collection called Shared With Me. So if I go into Shared With Me, and here's the sample file that I just shared with the student. Now, once a file is shared with somebody, what they can do is they can add it to their My Drive. So right now, this file is not something that is part of their collection, their organized collection of files and folders. If they'd like it to be, they need to click this little button up here that says Add to My Drive, or they could just right-click it and say Add to My Drive. Both will work the same way. So I'm going to add that to My Drive. And when you do that, you can put it somewhere. Now, I can put it right at the base of My Drive, or I can put it in a particular folder. Let's put it in Important Files, for example. And I'll say Move. And so I've now moved that. If I go back to My Drive, and I look in Important Files, there is the file I've just shared. Now, the beauty of this system is this is the same file we're looking at. Both people have access to the same file. It's not two copies of the same file. It's actually the same file. And the beauty is that each user can file it in their own particular way. So if this student decided to put it in another folder, so let's just do that. Let's go to a new folder, and we'll call this new, and we'll go create. So there's new folder. If I take this and move it and drop it into that new folder, it's now in a completely different location. None of those changes about where that file lives affects the original owner of that file. The original owner will see it wherever they filed it, and the second participant, the collaborator, will be able to put it anywhere they like and file it wherever they like. Neither of those changes will affect the other. Okay, first thing to understand. The second thing is you can do the same thing with folders. So I can take this folder and I can share that folder with DStudent, Demo Student, there you go, and I'll let the Demo Student be an editor in this case, so I'll say Send. And that's been shared. If I go back over to the student view and I look in Shared With Me, and I might now just refresh this just to speed it up. So I'll just refresh that page. There you go. So there is the folder called Work Files that was shared from the teacher. And again, if I want to claim that into my collection, I'd need to select it and either click this button up here that says Add to My Drive, or right click it and say Add to My Drive. Both do the same thing. So let's do it the other way this time. And I've now added it to My Drive. And you can even see, let's just put it in the base of My Drive. Okay, you can even see now that it will tell me, if I go to My Drive, here is the Work Files folder. Now, I can file that, I can move that around as well. I can take this and I can drop it into the Important Files folder there like that. I can go into there and I can take it and drop that into the new folder. I can move that folder full of stuff around anywhere I like, and it won't affect the other person's view of it. So we have our own filing systems of the same material. It's pretty clever the way that works. Now here is the catch. If I, as the user, as the person who's having it shared with them, not the owner of the file, if I go in and take something here, so if I take this, go in here and say take one of these objects here, let's just open this up. So let's say I want to take this thing called My Essay, and I want to drop it into this folder called Science. If I take that and drop it down there in Science, I get a warning that tells me if I'm moving this out of the shared folder, other users will no longer be able to see this file. In other words, if I move it out of the folder that was shared with me, it would no longer be visible to the other users. Let's just do it and make sure that works. I've removed the document. If I come back to the teacher view now and look in Work Files, Just give it a second to catch up. Just refresh the page to speed that up. You'll notice that the essay is now gone. And the reason it's gone is because the user I shared it with moved it out of the folder. So the rule is this. You can share a file with somebody. They can put it anywhere they like. It won't affect you. You can share a folder with somebody and they can move it anywhere they like and it won't affect you. But if they take a file out of a shared folder, it will remove the file from the folder. And when you think about it, that's actually not strange behavior at all. If on the Windows file server, for example, if someone was to take a file out of a folder, it would no longer be in the folder. And this is the same here. So there's no difference. It's just because, because there are some situations where you can move stuff around that it may confuse you a little bit when there's this one instance where you can't. So just remember the rule. If it's in a shared folder, don't move files out of the shared folder. You can take an entire copy of the folder if you like. That's fine. It won't affect anyone else's view of it. But if you move something from within the folder, it will break everybody else's view of that object. Hope that makes sense.